blessings of God be upon everyone, and what is God? The super matrix, perfect purity, perfect clarity, perfect smoothness, no fluctuation, no pulsation, ever stillness, ground of being within which everything arises. So it's that which enables everything else to arise. So that is reality. The situation we're in is what's called whim, which is a desire to change reality. And since reality cannot be changed, it's a whim. This desire is a whim. Whim gives rise to a continuity problem. And so we all have a severe continuity problem. Now, there's a lot of teachings out in the world throughout history, in, you know, many, many very good teachings, okay? The difference with teachings is emphasis. What do you emphasize? Emphasis usually comes about because the times that are happening in any particular time, there seems to be a need to emphasize something. So in different times in the world, there'll be different emphasis. And we have to have a wide enough perspective where we don't get tripped up or bothered by that. We say, okay, you know, different emphasis, that's fine. Now, these times are very unique because we have this massive influx and an immigration, you might call it an invasion, of a mindset into this world that we haven't seen here before. Super, super arrogant, idolatrous mindset that is bent on secular materialism and using force. The almost everything we see in our world is manufactured through the use of force, pressure, different types, heat pressure, electrical pressure, you know, the hydraulic pressure. You look at manufacturing process, everything's manufactured. It's all pressure. This whole system of whim is based on applying pressure, demand. We think that we can change reality by pressurizing it, you know, heating it up, using force, you know, to melt stuff. We melt stuff, we grind it up, we cut it, we stamp it, we extrude it, you know, we heat it up to such, you know, change its molecular structure and everything. So we think that we can change the structure of reality. But the ground of being is immutable because it's the perfect absence of all qualities. Utter absence, pure stillness. No, so there's nothing to change there. All changes are simply decorations in relation to the ground of being. So with this invasion of this planet, really, it's an invasion. It's a takeover of this planet. The old ways of emphasis, people are finding they're not supportive. They're not enough. You know, it's like, whoa, we're not dealing with this very well. They're crumbling and getting into confrontational situations, which is the last thing you want to do, is get into any sort of confrontational situation. Actually, you want to be dispassionate, because confrontation is force. And what you're doing is you're meeting force with force. Okay. Keep in mind, Jesus said, turn the other cheek, love your enemy. Love one another, love your enemy. Agree with your enemy, you know, agree. Don't fight force with force. That puts you in this deluded situation that you're believing that reality can be changed through force. So we have a situation in the world right now where the old ways are simply being steamrolled and crumbling and not supportive anymore. Doesn't mean that their doctrine is wrong. It just means that their emphasis dealing with past situations needs to be widened up, shift of emphasis. And that's what's happened in my life. My emphasis has shifted in order to deal with this crisis. There's a crisis in the world. You cannot just continue to think that the old ways of emphasis are sufficient. You have to look at it and say, is it sufficient? And if it's not, you just have to say, well, I need to be even clearer about it. Even clearer. You know, greater clarity is called for right now. I'm telling you, the mindset in the world right now, you're going to need, you know, ultimate clarity to sidestep it. They want to pull you into confrontation because that's what they're all about. Materialism sees everything as something to apply force to apply pressure to. So this mindset looks at everybody else as like matter, okay? And they say, how do we apply pressure to change this matter? It's all about changing, reforming, reshaping, changing through pressure. So they look at society as something to be shaped and formed, like we form a sheet metal into an automobile, right? And so they work at it from that standpoint of how do we use force to get what we want. So that's what they're doing. That's what they're doing. So if you try to use force to change them, you're playing their game. You're playing their game, and they're better at it than you are. They're better at it because they've dedicated themselves to it more. And if you've been listening to the Holy Spirit, the grace of God clarify for you, you'll know that's not the way. That's not the way. So a lot of people in this world are not experts in applying force like myself. I couldn't manufacture anything. Simply using force is just something that does not come easy or naturally to me at all. So how do you can't counter them with force. They're going to absolutely crush you if you do that. So what you have to do, how do you sidestep them? Well, you need a new emphasis in your clarity. What really does it is simply clarity itself, great clarity. So this is the emphasis here. I'm not saying that other emphases aren't accurate. It's just that this one is designed to deal with the situation that we have right here, right now. And ultimately, it deals with the entire situation of materiality in a very, very good way, actually. The whole premise of this material existence is based on whim. And whim arises from the desire of spirit to change reality. Change it, why? So it can claim that it's God. Okay, so it says, hey, if I can change God, I must be greater than God. So the desire to change reality is really the desire to play God on the part of spirit. And this gives rise to whim, because it's a whimsical idea. You cannot experience it, so it's just whim. But whim gives rise to what's called a continuity problem. And that is, in following the advice of whim, the adventures, eventually you get so far off track, you have no idea what reality is like anymore. Because whim has painted this incredible adventure for you, and you've been on this adventure for so long, and you've forgotten, and you're totally used to believing in opinions, and believing in belief about reality, opinions of reality, belief about reality, all of this. So you have a severe continuity problem of dropping opinions. How do you drop opinions? We think opinions are life. You know, we really do. We believe that opinions about reality is life, is reality. That's whim. That is whim. To believe that opinions about reality is whim. So we're so used to this, we can't just drop it like that. Just cannot. Not pragmatically, we cannot. So what do we do? The prime creator that knows our problem and said, hey, it's a pragmatic situation. It's not a real problem, but it's a pragmatic one. So here's a creation, special creation, a special blessing upon our spirit, actually. It's a special blessing, a blessing upon our spirit called the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Wholeness. In other words, a blessing that reminds us of the wholeness, the holiness of reality, that it cannot be changed and doesn't need any opinions. And this Holy Spirit, this wholeness, Spirit of Wholeness, gives us a perception, its opinion, an opinion about reality, which actually reminds us of reality. Even though it's still an opinion, and it's not real, It's still a perception. There's still like a perceiver perception kind of thing. It's like we're perceiving holiness everywhere, without exception, which reminds us of reality. Because in reality, everything is included in it. There's no place other than reality. There isn't some place outside of reality. The idea you can be cast out of reality is nonsense. It's everywhereness. Reality, God is everywhereness. There's no place where God is not, where you aren't, where something is not abiding in spaciousness, pure spaciousness. So you can never leave it. Never leave it. Which is a good thing to know. Because we're afraid that, like, maybe our opinions are that we can be, you know, maybe close to it or get outside of it or something or separate from it. It's not true. That's a whim. But anyway, the Holy Spirit gives us a vision of holiness, of everything without exception appears to be holy to us, without exception, everything. This is how you sidestep the secular materialists, okay, is the vision of holiness. This is the remedy. This is the RX. This is what the doctor has ordered. And you can't come up short of that. You cannot come up short of that. You cannot just berate these people, these mindsets, you know, this very heavily idolatrous mindsets that are idolizing whim, basically. Disparaging them is not the way. Seeing them as holy is the way. Seeing everything as holy is the way. It's this feeling of sacredness, holiness, smooth, even, clear, transparently clear, translucent. Just everything is abiding in this field of pure holiness. And just seeing that. Now, there's still a perceiver, you know, still, okay, I am perceiving that. You don't need to get rid of the I necessarily, because I is just an opinion, right? When we think about, when we say I really means an opinion about reality. So we're not getting rid of opinions. So we don't need to struggle with this subjective, objective, all this stuff. It's not necessary. It's simply now we've been perceiving what we've been perceiving here, and now we're perceiving everything as equally holy without any exceptions. Still a perceiver and we're perceived. That's fine. But the smoothed out holiness of everything reminds us of reality, reminds spirit of reality. And then so spirit is able to drop all opinions about reality eventually. That's the second step. So our part is to take the first step. God takes the second step. We take the first step. Vision of holiness. Okay? Vision of sacredness. That is the goal. And anything short of that, you're going to get into a battle of force with these very forceful secular materialists. Extremely aggressive people. Very much so. Not a joke. I mean, this is severe. It's a crisis in the world right now. And their whole viewpoint is aggressive force, forcing you, molding you, shaping you, pouring you into a mold, heating you up, melting you down, pouring you into a mold, reshaping you, remaking you. That's what it's all about, what their whole viewpoint is. And history will, you know, shows you that, of what's going to take place in this world, is that mindset builds up pressure. See, if they don't get their way, they just keep upping the pressure. It's kind of like if you're trying to melt ore or something, you know, it's not melted yet. You keep turning up the heat and the pressure until finally it melts. That's their mindset. That is their mindset. Melt it down. Of course, this mindset brings upon a meltdown upon them as well. Cosmic meltdown, actually, which is, I've seen, is going to take place on this planet. I don't want to be around for that, that's for sure. So this vision of holiness, what that does is it enables one to drop this whole idea of forcefulness, of force. And in dropping that, it enables one to enter into a realm where everything is perfect. Everything is continually refreshed. Everything is continually fresh. There's no death. There's nothing like that. Incredibly beautiful situation. where no force has to be applied to anything. So, and cannot be applied to anything. So the whole forceful mindset of this world prevents you from ascending. People call it the kingdom of heaven, the fifth dimension, paradise, all this, the death-free realm. Eventually, everybody has to enter into the death-free realm because God did not make us for death, you see. We're trying to apply death to ourselves. It's a whim. It's an opinion about reality. That reality can die. It can be changed. It can come to an end. It's not true. So a forceful mindset cannot find peace in the death-free realm, the paradise realm, because there's nothing there to change. So the mindset is simply to look out on everything and say, everything is so exquisitely beautiful. Why would I want to even change a leaf? I don't need to apply force to anything. Everything's already exactly exquisite, perfectly exquisite, just as it is. Just as it is, it's perfectly exquisite. That mindset then will enable you to, quote unquote, ascend into the higher realms, the death-free realms, and ultimately sidestep the tribulation that come here, the troubles, which are likely can come about very quickly. The pressure has been building. It hasn't happened yet. It's almost happened several times. And I've been saying, look at these warning signs, and it might happen, it might not, but keep working as fast as possible because it's going to happen eventually. The pressure builds up. That's how materiality, the materialists work. Apply pressure until they get their way. Apply pressure until they get their way. That they don't have any other mindset. They're not going to listen to you saying, you know, your doctrine, you're preaching your doctrine of salvation to them. They're not going to listen. This is very important to understand. They're not going to listen. They're just going to keep applying pressure to you until you break. That's what they do. That's how they make all these metals. That's how they make all these things, plastics, everything you see. You know, they you know, to get the ore, they boom, you know, and then they get the big, huge, heavy equipment and scoop it up, load it on trains, bring it to the factory, you know, process it, stamp it, all this. It's pressure. And that's all they know, is applying pressure. So, you don't want to subject yourself to that kind of pressure. And this kind of teaching here is extremely difficult because when you come into this world, all this pressure is applied to you, which is what I experienced. It took me to the age of 12 before I finally, you know, melted down. But up until that time, I was resistant to it. But the pressure is relentless here. There's the world of materialism. There's relentless pressure in the school system, in all systems, all institutions. Everything is based on applying pressure to get a result. So I basically melted down at 12 and then have had to, you know, try to get this clarity back, which is has not been easy at all, very difficult. So you rarely hear this type of teaching here simply because the pressure is too severe. It's too severe here. And we tend to just get into a forceful struggle with force, you know, and thinking that we can overcome them. And a lot of people believe that Jesus is coming back ahead of an army to destroy, you know, to use superior force to crush the secular materialists. That's not true. There may be a war or battle, but that's not Christ that's doing that. How could Christ, the one who says, love your enemy, lay down your swords, you know, turn the other cheek, how could that be the head of some mighty army coming to use superior force to melt down the materialists? Now, come on, use your, you know, let the Holy Spirit clarify that for you. No, the return is to lift those who are dispassionate, who want to stop using force, and to return to accept reality as first be reminded of the nature of reality, so they can then fully accept that they never left reality. They'll be lifted up in some way, to a place where force is not necessary. Actually, imagine a world where no force is necessary. There are such places, absolutely. where everything out of love simply manifests for you without any use of force whatsoever. It's lunacy. It's not how reality works. I mean, these are just decorations in pure spaciousness, but the idea that somehow it's pure spaciousness is being changed is fantasy. It's a whim. And so it's just, you know, it's meaningless. It's absolutely meaningless. So the right preparation is to be in beautiful places where you simply, the more that you look at and just feel like, ah, this is just perfect just as it is. This is just perfect just as it is. I don't need to do anything. I don't even need to cut a blade of grass. I mean, it's just let it be everything. Just let it be just exactly as it is. That is very helpful training. Very helpful training. I've had some of that training. I'd like some more, as a matter of fact. I really would. A sense of spaciousness, a sense of to everything just as it is, allowing it to be just as it is. No conflict, no force, no need to overcome anything. Reality is not a situation of overcoming something. That's why Jesus said, don't try to overcome evil. It's whim, actually. How can you overcome whim? Whim is whimsical. You just simply have to drop whim. And just say, I no longer want to be prime creator. I no longer want to try and change reality. And we have a continuity problem with this. So first we have to be reminded of the holiness of everything. See the holiness. Perceive it. Not know it. That's the final step, is to know it. But our step is to perceive it. So it's healing is perceptual. Okay, healing is at the level of perception. The level of knowing doesn't need any healing. But perception does need healing. In other words, opinions do need a final opinion, that opinions aren't necessary. Okay, that's the continuity issue. This is the high teaching of these times. We've received high teachings for these times, okay? And those who have, you know, picked up on that, very good. They're not going to get into a forceful contest, a contest of force with the, you know, the secular materialists, the idolaters, idolizing whim out of their desire to be greater than God. So it's my prayer that everybody right now who is going to sidestep the problem find themselves in a very beautiful, tranquil, peaceful place where they look out upon and they say, ah, just perfect, I don't want to change anything. Now, this is not the vision of holiness yet, but it certainly gets one into the mood, okay? Become dispassionate. Don't try to use force to change something. So just, and then eventually the vision of sacredness, which is healed perception, eventually that will come. It will come. It's there. I trust in those who told us it's there. And it's just a matter of preparing for it and removing the blocks, you know, the fear. Remove the blocks from it. Keep removing the blocks. You're blocked in some way. We're all blocked in some way. So instead of, you know, criticizing others, it's better to remove your own block. Keep working on removing your own blocks. How are you blocked from vision of holiness? In other words, seeing everyone, everything as holy, equally sacred, because it is. Everything is equally in the pure spaciousness of God. So everything's equally holy, no question about it. It doesn't matter what their whim is. It doesn't matter what opinions they have about it. I mean, all opinions also are holy, sacred and holy. In the sacred holiness of pure spaciousness, all opinions are also there. So judge not lest you be judged. Judge not lest you believe in judgment. And judgment meaning what? That something is less in pure spaciousness and something is more? That's insanity. That's whim. So don't judge. In other words, see everything equal vision, same. Now, of course, those who believe in force, they don't like that, because their whole thing is we need to change that. We need to see some as more and some as less and change it, so they apply pressure to you to change it. This pressure is really very intolerable. Only those who are perfectly in the know of reality, know reality, can brush this pressure aside. We're not at that point, okay? So you need to be humble at this point. Humility is very important. You say, you know what, I'm not there yet. I'm not there yet. So I do need help. I'm not there yet, I do need help. A lot of help, actually. Because the pressure that is coming in this world, building up, is super intense. And unless you're actually in the know, knowing reality, in the know, and none of us are, then you're going to be subjected to this pressure. Could be very much problematical for you. And it's told in the scriptures that during the end of the cycle, the pressure will get so severe that even the elect of God will crumble, or in danger of crumbling from it. And that's true, that we're here now. We're now on December 22nd, 2013. We're now here. I say the tribulation period is now underway. It's now underway. So we now have chosen either to follow the opinions of whim or the opinion of the Holy Spirit about reality. Do we keep following the opinions, the constant, ever-varying, changing opinions of whim about reality, which is just endless turmoil, right? Constantly new opinion, this opinion, that opinion about reality. Of course, none of it true, because reality is beyond all opinion. Or do we follow the one opinion of the Holy Spirit, which is to see healed perception, which is see equal sacredness, holiness, everything is abiding it without any exception. That is the opinion of the Holy Spirit about reality, okay? And it's still perceptual, so you're still on familiar ground. It's still an opinion, it's still perception, there's still a sense of I'm seeing this, you know. That's so it you know, it's not a continuity issue for us, not a big one. And it resolves the continuity issue. So we're at that point now, December 22nd, 2013, is you have to know in your heart, you know, which direction am I going? So at this point, I expect miracles. I do expect, you know, pragmatic miracles to take place. And I'm certainly waiting for that, planned for that. I reached my goal. I had a certain goal by this day, to weigh a certain weight, and I was like almost a whole pound underneath it. I went an all-out effort yesterday and did it, you know, did it. 40 days of all-out effort and succeeded. So we're in a new phase now of the world history. We're in a new phase right now. Should be separated from the chaff now, the wheat from the tares, the noxious weeds that are worshiping whim and all the reifications that it makes. Whim says, hey, look, you can change this. Look at this decoration, this body. You can change that body. You can change this. You can, you know, use force to change stuff. You can get good enough at force that you can actually change reality. And you know, a lot of spirits are following that, you know, like, wow, that's really cool, really interesting. So, what is next? I don't know. I keep an open mind. I don't know. Keep an open mind. Recognize that we do need help. We are not as high as we need to be. We are not yet. Even those who have the vision of holiness, even they are in danger in this world as far as pressure goes. Only those who know reality can just brush it aside. Those are the great teachers we've had. They know reality, and nothing here bothers them. Nothing. They don't flinch. No flinching. Nothing bothers them. They don't even need to use force at all. They're just, you know, it's completely blissful, calm, peaceful like that. Only those are in trouble, cannot be bothered by the pressure. Everybody else is subject to severe pressures. Even if you have the vision of holiness, there'll be severe pressure to drop it. Severe pressure, actually. So all this remains to be seen. However, congratulations to everybody for getting this far, because it was a monumental effort. For me, I almost gave up. I reached a point 40 days ago where I said, you know what, I can't make it. Too much pressure. And then the Holy Spirit said, hey, you know, come on, you know, one last effort. I said, no, it's too much. And then finally I got convinced that, you know, if I don't do it, I'm gonna regret it forever. You know, I'm just gonna regret it forever, it seems like. I just couldn't live with myself if I didn't, you know, at least give it one last try. Even though I've given so many and I'm tired of trying, I said, okay, one final push. And I finally, you know, I did it. So it's a great thing. So, what step will be taken next? What will the Holy Spirit do for the world at this time, for those who have going toward this dispassion, true dispassion, dropping for the need for force, accepting the opinion of the Holy Spirit about reality, which is the vision of equal vision, the vision of sameness, the vision of holiness, the vision of sacredness, vision of smoothed out spaciousness, perfect overlay, vision of oneness, etc. That opinion of reality of the Holy Spirit, move towards accepting that as your final opinion, final perception. What will be done for those? We'll find out. I'm still, you know, open-minded and trying to produce things here and offer them up to people that try to, you know, get us ready for that. But still, the future is, you know, right now it's not clear how we're going to be helped. But I'm certainly ready to be helped, and I hope everybody else is too. Again, we're going not towards condemnation or judgment of anyone, but towards the vision of sacredness, holiness of everything without exception, because that opinion is in alignment with reality, the fact that nothing can ever leave the everlasting arms of pure, smoothed out spaciousness that is the super matrix that we call God. It can never crystallize at all. It can never crystallize. It can never be reified, never concretized. Never, never, never. There's nothing, no crystallization possible of this pure spaciousness. Therefore, you cannot use force on it whatsoever. It's a fact, and it remains a fact, and it remains a fact that we are in that always. Everything is always in that. Nothing can ever leave it. And so this whole fantasy of leaving that is just a useless waste of time, really. So, we accept the final opinion. We're going towards accepting the final opinion, the one opinion of the Holy Spirit, the one opinion of reality that resolves the continuity problem that whim has given rise to. So this is the teaching. This is the teaching that I teach, share, and it's the teaching that has the escape velocity that is necessary for these times, where you can brush aside those who are idolizing whim. Okay, it's possible, and we'll do it. All right. Very great. That's it.